Go. You can take it.
No, no, you take it. The department stud can't go hungry.
Department stud? When has anyone ever referred to me as the department stud?
Oh, the host of a very misleading podcast, that's who?
Come on, really? The podcast? You're still on that?
I'm still on that. I don't know, maybe, maybe not. Because the podcast boy has taken it upon himself to erase my contributions. And what makes matters worse, he won't return my phone calls. So yeah, I think I'm still on that. Oh, come on.
Come on, what are you doing?
I am just making this easy on you guys.
All right, guys, what do we know?
Well, we know that Sam sent Emma flowers after he landed in Florida.
And we know the cops found the flowers on the Radner's porch.
Which, according to the original cops on the case, meant that the flowers were delivered after Emma had already been killed.
But we also know that Emma not only saw the flowers, but she took one of them.
So you gotta think that she brought the vase inside.
But according to the original police report, there were no prints on the vase.
All right, so someone kills her, wipes the vase clean, then plants the flowers back on the porch to frame Sam? No evidence of forced entry.
Who else had access to the house?
We don't know. But we got the guy who would.
So, that's it? I can go?
Yes, as soon as we process you out.
Thank you for believing in me.
Well, we believe in the evidence, which proves that you did not kill Emma.
But then who did?
We don't know, but we're hoping you can help us.
No, I don't know anything.
Who would have access to your house besides your sister-in-law, Molly?
There was our friend, Walt Freeman.
Emma's old coworker.
Why exactly did he have a key?
He'd come over and water our plants when we'd go on vacation. He'd do some handyman stuff.
And what was Emma and Walt's relationship like?
Close. I mean, she was his teaching assistant, her first job out of college. Then he became her mentor and eventually a father figure.
Any chance Walt wanted something more?
Walt? Are you kidding? No. And they were just friends.
Well, sometimes friendships turn into infatuations.
And infatuations turn into obsessions.